to celebrate this much-awaited event. We are here as guests, but more importantly, we gather as witnesses of the Lord's gentle, loving care of His flock. Since His Holiness Pope Benedict XVI appointed Bishop John F. Doe last February 25, the whole Archdiocese of Palo has been preparing and waiting for this momentous event. Today, we come together to celebrate this rare occasion, the installation of the new Archbishop of Palo. Through the rite of installation, the administration of the Metropolitan See of Palo will formally be entrusted to the Most Reverend John F. Doe, Dean, in the presence of representatives of the Church hierarchy in the Philippines, government officials of Leyte and region, the clergy and religious of Palo, and representatives of the various parishes, ecclesiastical communities, and lay organizations within the Archdiocese and the Metropolitan Province. We rejoice for this gift from the Almighty, and we pray so that God, who has been so gracious to us, may continue to direct our ways and lead our path towards the common goal He has set before us this year.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
We shall now witness the rite of canonical installation.
Let the apostolic letter be shown and read.
The Chancellor of the Archdiocese, Reverend Father Rick Marva, will now read to us the Papal Bull.
Optamos en super, los clérigos y populus, tranquillitate ovunque, suavitate docere. E ipe scrivite se, venerabile strada, adottando l'umanius del nome Christe, e montitavo apostolis ole prelati, non in Iglesia Valensi precinque memorandum. Dubis fidelibus testi vigeres, e obor semper ricordibus disciplorum luces scandalum tollens. Eus quoque ad celestem supremum finem perducas. Dato ormai apur Santo Pedro di Decisimo Pinto, mensis retruari, anno Domini, decilissimo, dodicimo, pontificatus nostre, septimo. Benedictus, sextus, decimo. Bene, Bishop, servant, and servants of God. To the venerable brother John Consuelo Du, until now Bishop of Dumaguete, now Archbishop elect of the Metropolitan Church of Palo, bringing an apostolic benediction. Among the most particular and principal duties of the Roman Pontiff is indeed that of assessing with every diligence the care and portions of the one man of the Lord may have solicitous pastors. While the faithful of Palo await another bishop, after the transfer of their last pastor, the venerable brother Jose Espalma, to the Cathedral Church of the Holy Name of Jesus, we turn our mind to you, our venerable brother, that as you have prudently governed the Dumaguete community until now, so do we still, that you will also be able to govern the Palo community just as wisely. Consequently, through the advice of the Congregation for Bishops, by our ordinary apostolic power, we declare and appoint you free from the bond of the Church of Dumaguete as Palo Metropolitan Archbishop, bestowed with the rights and obligations prescribed by our law. Besides, we desire that the clergy and the people of your archdiocese may know this, our present decree and decision, and accept you as their pastor and protector in the spirit of true goodwill. Moreover, the Christian faithful shall be committed to you, to teach with every steadfastness and gentleness. Venerable brother, we encourage you, writing to you these things, so that you may bear witness to the great splendor of Christ, once revealed to the apostles in the Mount Tabor, now particularly remembered in the Church of Palo, that by it, removing the scandal of the cross from the hearts of the disciples, you may also lead them towards the highest celestial end. Given in Rome, at St. Peter's, on the 25th day of the month of February, in the year of the Lord, 2012, the 7th of our pontificate, Benedict the 16th.
As a gesture of our appreciation and gratitude to the Holy Spirit. The Apostolic Nuncio, most reverend Giuseppe, will now present the pastoral staff to the new Archbishop of the Law as a sign of entrusting pastoral care of the Again, we give our honor. Our new Archbishop will now be greeted by his sovereign, the bishops present, the clergy of the law, the government officials, and representatives of religious